Hello everyone, and welcome to the 2012 edition of NC Ongoings. Now, in this video, I am going to be going through all of the changes and improvements and everything there is to pretty much know about the new design for NC Ongoings. Now, I'm not going to go through every last bit of detail that, you know, that everyone would want to know about because, you know, there's been quite a lot of changes from the previous version. And I'm going to go through most of the important ones in this video. Any of the other ones will simply be shown as, you know, will just appear throughout the show for the most part. So I'm not going to go through every last update there is and every last improvement. I'm just going to go through the ones that everyone needs to know about. So without further ado, let's get into this and I hope you enjoy the episode. First, I'm going to be going through the My Update section. Now, as I'm sure you probably noticed, the My Update section is going to be undergoing quite a bit of a change. I'll go through all of that in this video. But the first thing I want to talk about that I feel might be the most important update out of all of them is the upload frequency, or frequent of uploads, for NC Ongoings. Now, beforehand, NC Ongoings was always once a week. I'm changing that. That is no longer going to be the case. From this point onwards, NC Ongoings will be uploaded when an episode simply can be made. The reason I decided to change this is because for some weeks when NC Ongoings was meant to be up, there simply was not anything to go by basically. There was no videos to review, there was no updates to cover, there was nothing to basically cover, and if there was anything, it wasn't really enough to make an episode out of. So instead of making it once a week, I'm actually going to be going through this whenever an episode can be made. So from this point onwards, don't expect NC Ongoings to be on every week. Instead, it'll simply go up when I can get one up with the sufficient content that I can provide. Now, a lot of you may be wondering, well, isn't that just an excuse to be a bit more lazy? Well, yes and no. It is true that with this change, NC Ongoings might not be as common as it was before. However, excuse me, it might actually work in reverse also. There might be some weeks where two episodes could go up. Say there's like a load of content to be working my way through, but it's way too much to simply put into one video. For some weeks, you could find that there may be two episodes going up. I don't think it'll be any more than two a week. And for the most part, there might be some weeks where no NC Ongoings goes up. For the most part, it probably will be once a week whenever I can get one up. So you guys get the idea on that note. So that update out of the way, let's move on. The next change is, of course, I'm going to be talking about this section, which is My Update. Now, the My Update section from now on will be done like this. I will be doing it in person. I'll be displaying the updates here. And that's really all there is to say about the My Update. So this might be the biggest change over from the last version, but that's for you guys to decide because, like I said previously, there is still quite a lot of changes being made from the previous version. But from now on, just so you guys know, the My Update section will be done like this. My reasons for changing this is because I always thought that the old version was a bit on the bland side. I think people might get bored just staring at an update screen all the time. So I figured that it might be a lot more entertaining, possibly, and more fun to watch, maybe, if I did it like this. Because let's face it, people would much rather see it like this, wouldn't they, than staring at a board all the time. So, you know, that's basically my reasons for making this change. Now, another thing that's going to be changed commonly among the new NC Ongoings is there's going to be a bunch of sections that are going to be removed. Now, don't get me wrong, it's not that I'm actually taking out anything, it's more like some sections are absorbing what previous sections did. For example, the Gamers on 26 coverage section is being completely removed. I'm not going to use the section any longer. Instead, anything that is covered by Gamers on 26 will be done on this section, which is the My Updates. I've done this because what's the point in having Gamers on 26 coverage when I can simply announce it here on the My Updates section, because at the end of the day, they are my updates. So why limit it to two specific sections? Why not just put it all under one section? And another change that's going to be made is the game news is being completely removed and is being replaced with the gaming article. Now, the gaming article is a section that I used to do on an older episode of NC Ongoings. I'm bringing this section back for this time period and probably for the foreseeable future. But anything that the game news covered will be covered from now on the gaming article. Now, speaking of two last things I want to go through, the video linkage and the video priority update sections are also being removed. Now, don't get me wrong, like I said, anything that is being removed is being taken over by another section. Now, I should point out that the reason the video priority update section is being removed is because of an update I'm going to be going through in a minute, but the video linkage will be explained in more detail in the next section, which will be the What's New section. Now, this moving into my last update, and possibly a rather notable update for the channel itself. I am completely removing the video priority scale. Right, that from this point onwards, there will no longer be a video priority scale. Now, you guys may be asking, well, how is it going to work from this point onwards when it comes to how often something will be uploaded? How it will work from this point onward is the new design is going to work similar to the previous one, but not exactly the same. Instead, I'm going to be getting a series and simply giving it its very own upload frequent. Right, so here's a classic example right here. Say you've got a list, it'll be PBR, Mario Kart Wii, Pokemon of the Week. PBR will say be put out twice, three times a week. Mario Kart Wii will be twice a week. PBR will be once a week. If I go as far as into Pokemon comparison could say once every 2 weeks or once a month. Basically, I'm removing the levels. There's no longer going to be any levels, and things are not going to be specifically put under a specific level. Instead, they are getting their own upload frequency, or frequent of uploads, however you want to put it. Now, the reason I've decided to do this is because in the past, I've always found like if there's something in specific I want to put on a specific upload time, the video priority scale hasn't really covered that sort of thing. It simply has not worked for the series. With this change, I can finally do that. And plus, it'll provide more accuracy as to how often something will be uploaded. So, I think you guys get the picture on how I'm going to be doing this from here on out. You know, I know this isn't a drastic change compared to the previous one, but keep in mind this new way is more accurate and it is a lot more useful on my end and possibly everyone else's end also. So, that's really all there is to say about the main updates. As for new sections, I'm going to be going over those in a minute on the What's New section. So, without further ado, let us press on. If you're wondering why I'm not using my camera for this section and instead I'm using my microphone, it's actually because there's quite a lot of screen shifting on this section, so I decided it would be better to use the microphone instead. Now, this time round, I am going to be talking about the brand new sections that have been added to NC Ongoings. Going to go through exactly what they are in detail, and that's really all there is to say. Now, you would expect me to talk about the gaming article, but to tell you the truth, people, I haven't actually completely finished making the new gaming article yet. There's still a few finishing touches that need to be made to it, and in present state it's not exactly usable, but I am going to be adding it in hopefully in the next episode, but if not the episode after that. But you guys will get a better idea of that section when it is officially a new section. So chances are there will be another What's New section up in the next episode or the episode after that, so expect that sometime soon. So now moving on to the coverage of the actual new sections. Now, the first section is one that I want to go through, and it is actually a section that I used to do back in the early days of NC Ongoings, and this is basically going to be coverage of threads on the Pokemon Lance forums. And to those of you that are early, old-school NC Ongoings viewers, you'll know that I used to do coverage of the U-Titans forums, but that forum is gone now, so I'm going to be doing the Pokemon Lance forums instead. Now, to those of you who don't know what I'll simply be doing, I'll explain. It's actually very basic. I simply get threads from the actual forums that people have sent in, and I simply read it out, and then I respond to it. And I also respond to a lot of the replies that people have left to that thread as well. To be honest, it's going to be a lot like comment time, except doing threads on a forum, in this case Pokemon Lads forums. So, as always, you'll get a much better idea of what that will be like when I actually make that section, but I think this is a good section to have in, due to the fact that the Pokemon Lads forums often does get very interesting threads that I've always wanted to respond to, and with this new mode, I finally can do that. Well, I say finally, but you know, it's not really finally, is it? But anyway, that's basically the first new section I'm going to be doing. As always, if you have any questions on is there anything that you're confused about, then let me know. So, moving on to the next news section now. The next news section is actually a section that I've just been wanting to do for quite a long time, but I decided to save it until this year's NC Ongoings. Now, one of the things I get commonly asked through private message or sometimes through comments is, can you please give me a shout out on your next video, or specifically your NC Ongoings videos. Now, this new section I'm going to be adding in is a section called Helping Hand. Now, this is, think of this as a simple advertisement section. Right, it's also going to be what takes over what Video Linkage used to do. So if you've got any videos that you want me to basically give you a shout out for, you can feature them on this section. If you want a generalized channel shout out, I again can feature you under this section. And also, it's not even just limited to YouTube. If you've got a forum or an event or anything that you basically want people to know about, simply send it in, and if I think it's worthy enough, I will feature it on this show. And chances are not many people are going to send this in right off the bat, so anything that people do send in, I most likely will feature right from the get-go. So, moving on to the last section now, which is the last new section for this show. The last section that's going to be added on is actually something that I'm only going to take a brief moment to explain. It is called NC News. Now, this news section is a fun little section that is going to be a lot like Random Content of the Week. Now, what is the section going to be? I will simply get something that I've recently come across, or someone has sent to me, or someone has said. I will put it under this section and attempt to make some humour out of it. Now, I know my humour is actually a bit bland and boring at times, so you have to forgive me if I do anything terrible. But honestly, if you guys like this section, then I hope you do. Well, we're glad that you do if you do like it. But to put it simply, it's going to be a lot like Random Content of the Week. I am still going to try and feature Random Content of the Week on every last episode, but just think of this as an extension onto that. So I can't really explain what it's going to be like, because it's going to be a pretty randomized section, but I hope you guys will enjoy it. Now, before I finally move on to the last section, I would actually like to go over three last things that I'm going to be adding on to the show in general. Or rather, to be more specific, the first two are changes to actual sections. The third one is a new little thing I'm going to be adding to the show in general, but it's not an actual new section. The first real change that's being made is actually an addition that I'm adding on to my Ask and Answer section. Now, as I'm sure you've noticed, here is a golden banner, where the blue banner, the blue regular banner, changes to the golden banner. Now, what is this all about? Basically, this is a small little addition I've made to Ask and Answer, whereas if I get a number of questions, I will handpick myself which one I think was the most creative and awesome target of the entire set, and that question I pick will become the golden question. And there is actually rewards for actually getting on to the golden question. Now, these rewards can range from getting a moderator or admin promotion on the chat room if you go there quite a lot. It can range to generalized Pokemon trades, so if there's a specific Pokemon you want, I can send you one. And also generalized shoutouts as well. I know I have the helping hand section, but if I say someone gets onto this sort of golden question, then maybe you might get yourself a channel review or just a generalized shout out, but I'll go the little extra mile because you won the Ask and Answer Golden Question competition. I know that's a bit of a long name, I probably should give it a more fitting title, but that's basically what this is. If you get onto this section, you could potentially win a prize. So I know this is going to seem like a little bit on the whorish side and all that, but I thought it'd be a fun little thing to do because I do get a decent supply of people send me questions in, so I figured this might be a fun little thing to be able to do to perhaps give people a little incentive to perhaps compete for this reward. So that's really all to say about that change. Now moving on to the next one. And the second thing I want to talk about is actually changes being made to the What's New section. This is basically getting a generalized expansion on what it already covered. Up until now, it only covered stuff like new NC ongoing sections, new shows in general, and stuff like that. Well, now I'm going to be expanding that to new shows or new stuff generalized on the internet. Now you may be wondering, well, what about the Helping Hand section? Doesn't that cover this sort of thing? Well, it does, but this is actually for stuff that hasn't been requested for. So if there's something that I think people should know about, but no one's actually asked a request for, I can announce that sort of thing on this section also. I've also thought about perhaps doing coverage of the smog from Smogon, on my thoughts on things mentioned in that, and also maybe congratulating certain people when they hit a certain amount of subscribers. So generalized stuff like that, you know, I know it's not a gigantic boost, but I think it'll make the What's New section more interesting and fun to watch. So finally, I'll come on to the last thing that's going to be new to this show, and that is interactive segments. Now, I know this is not my own idea. I know loads of people that already do this sort of thing, but I have decided to go ahead and throw in interactive segments. Now, to those of you who don't know what interactive segment is, it's basically this. Some people, when they put videos on YouTube, they enable annotation links, so as when a certain point in the video comes, you click on the option, it takes you to a new video, and it basically, you know, it's an interactive segment, it lets you choose what will come next. I've decided to include this sort of thing on NC Ongoings because I think it'll just, again, add to the list of things that we can do here. That's all there is to say about interactive segments, so moving on to our last section of this week's episode. I know this episode has been a bit on the long side, so thank you very much for being patient with me and sticking through to this point in the video. Now, up next. Now, the first thing I want to talk about is my blogging. I know I've been putting out quite a lot of blogs lately. Yeah, it's quite funny because I usually don't put out that many blogs by default, but lately I've been putting out quite a lot of blogs. But for that reason, I am going to tone down the blogs just a little bit so that, you know, you guys don't get sick of it being the constant blogging over and over again. So next week onwards, I probably will start uploading video game videos like usual, and also maybe throwing a blog or two every week. Now, that's all there is to say about blogging. Now, PBR and Mario Kart Wii. Mario Kart Wii Season 2 will resume next week. Well, I should say start next week, actually, because Season 2 hasn't officially started yet. But Season 2 of Mario Kart Wii will start next Monday, so keep your eyes open for that. As will Pokemon of the Week. I know there was not a Pokemon of the Week this week. I apologize for that. But there will be one next Monday, so again, look forward to that. Now, also regarding PBR will be pretty much the same as always. Unfortunately, I haven't actually told anyone this, but right now, I am actually unable at this present point in time to doing Pokemon DS Wi-Fi videos. Now, the reason for this is, unfortunately, the tripod I was using unfortunately got broke. It's my own fault, actually. I should actually be more careful, but I basically got the nozzle part where the camera goes onto. I accidentally pulled it back by mistake and snapped it, didn't I? So unfortunately my tripod is broken. Now the good news is I have got a new one on its way, but it's currently been ordered off eBay and, you know, I'm expecting that sometime soon, but at present I'm unable to do it DS Wi-Fi videos, so that'll be on hold until I can get ourselves a new tripod. And that's pretty much all there is to say. Oh, except for Pokemon Comparison, Pokemon comparison should be out towards the end of this month and maybe the start of next month. Unfortunately, it's still in building stages. I'm still working on the Season 2 format for that. So look forward to that sometime in the future. So don't hold me, Pokemon comparison will be out eventually, but at present it's still on hold. And I think that's pretty much everything to say, except for random content of the week. There will not be a random content of the week this week, sadly, because this episode of NC Ongoings was uploaded mainly to let everyone know what was going to be happening with the show and my channel in general. But random content of the week will start up next week, as will any other section for, well, I say next week, it'll be whenever the next NC Ongoings goes up. Yeah, I know, I still haven't gotten used to the fact that NC Ongoings isn't once a week anymore. So anyway, people, so that's pretty much all there is to say. As always, if you have any questions you want to send in, if you have any ask and answer questions you want to compete for the golden question for, again, feel free to send that in. So that brings us to the end of the first 2012 episode of NC Ongoings. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was educational. I hope it answered the questions you may have had about the new edition. So thank you very much for watching, people. I once again thank you very much for sticking with me for this long, you know, not just for this video but in general. So anyway, guys, I've gone on for way too long. You're probably sick of hearing me by now. So thank you for watching. Peace out, people, and cheers.